Welcome to an open source arithmetic course offered to anyone completely free as part of the 2012 AZSCITECH Festival. In this video, I will give a brief background to how the course was created, and then we'll enter the course to show all of its features. At the end of the video, I will provide contact information for anyone who wishes to register for the course. I hope you will find this course helpful. I've been creating open source math resources for almost 2 years now, but it wasn't until recently that I was able to combine open source videos that I've created with open source ebooks and an open source online assessment program to create standalone complete courses. For the arithmetic course, I combined my videos with the pre-algebra text written by College of the Redwoods with an online assessment program called WAMAP or iMathIS written by David Littman. The open source arithmetic course consists of 7 modules, and the topics are whole numbers, integers, fractions, decimals, ratios and proportions, percentages, and the fundamentals of algebra. So let's go take a look at the course. Once registered for the course, this will be your login screen. The first thing we want to do here is select Force Image-Based Display and then log in. Once we're logged in, we'll see the course here on the left. So if we click on here, we enter the course. Notice the first thing we see here is a calendar, but since this is an open source course, there are no due dates. Otherwise, the due dates would be posted here. Next, we see the announcements. If we click on this, I have a welcome announcement here. Again, this course is available to you to review all the major topics covered in an arithmetic or pre-algebra course. This course contains several features to help you successfully learn the concepts and test your understanding. This course offers a complete management system designed specifically for mathematics, including online assessments that provide instant feedback. Again, this program was written by David Littman of Pierce College. Here's a link for information on how to enter your answers. A complete ebook written by College of the Redwoods, which you can download or purchase here, and then video lessons and video examples produced by me. Under the announcements section, you'll see a discussion forum. There are 2 forums here. This first one is for general feedback about the course, so I hope you'll provide your honest feedback to make this course better. And then there's the Math Lounge, which is a place where you can actually post your math questions, and this is where students can help students learn the concepts. So if you have a question from an assessment, you can copy and paste it here. All of the math content is organized in a way that's very similar to a textbook. Notice how we have 7 modules. If we click on the first module, each module is broken down into sections. Again, just like a textbook. So if we click on section 1.1, there will always be 3 subsections within each section. The first link will be to the textbook for that specific section. The textbook is in PDF form, so this can be printed or saved. The next section consists of the videos, and there are 2 types of videos. There are video lessons and video examples. So the lessons develop the topic from the very beginning, and the examples are just additional examples. These are all hosted on YouTube and are from 5 to 10 minutes. So if we click on this video, you can watch the video and take notes as needed. Welcome to a lesson on place value and whole numbers. The goals of this video are to define counting numbers and whole numbers, determine place value of whole numbers, and then write whole numbers in expanded form. And there are also the video examples, which have the graph paper background. We went around 48,526 to the indicated place value. So after reading the textbook and watching the videos, you're ready for practice. So if we enter into homework 1.1, we have a problem set here. If we come to a question that we need help on, most of the questions do have a video help option here. So if we're not able to identify the correct place values for this number, we can click on this video help option. This opens up a new window, and it'll work a similar problem to the problem you're asked to solve. In this problem, we're given the number 53,981,476. We want to identify the place value of each of these given digits. Now, the homework questions do have an unlimited number of attempts. There are 2 attempts per version of the problem, so if we miss this problem twice, we can try a similar problem, which means this number will change, but we can still get full credit for the question. So if we happen to miss this question, we'll click Submit, and it'll show us that we missed the question. We have the option to reattempt the last question or try a similar question. If we reattempt this question again and miss it again, notice how the only option now is to try a similar problem or similar question, but notice how it also does give us the answer, so we can use this as an opportunity to review the concept as well. So notice how now we have a new version of the same problem. Notice how there's also an option to jump to the answer if we want to see the answer before working the question. Of course, if we do this, we would get a new version of the same problem for credit. So once we work through all of the sections and all of the homework, notice how here we have an optional practice test for the entire module. This is a good review of the entire module, and then we can test ourselves on the module test. So each module is laid out in the exact same way. So if we click on a module, we have the sections, and then within each section, we have the textbook, the videos, and the online homework. Notice at the bottom of the homepage, there's also a final exam to review all of the topics from the entire course. If you would like to register for this course, again, it is completely free. Please contact me, James Souza, at mathispowerforyou@live.com. I hope this course proves helpful.